The Indrani Hospital mystery thickens. In one of the most well-guarded prisons of India, Indrani Mukherjee, accused in the Sheena Bora murder case, fell unconscious. Now the hunt is on to find out what led to Indrani getting hospitalized.
This is what we are getting latest from the jail authorities here at Baikula as well, that they will be in fact conducting a probe and an internal inquiry and investigation into this whole matter to really find out where did Indrani Mukherjee get access to these excessive drugs which led to her overdose.
There are more questions than answers. Doctors say they found heavy presence of antidepressants in her body, the very same drug that had left Indrani hospitalized 3 years ago.
Indrani ke urine ka sample liya gaya tha aur wo jo drugs ya poisons ke liye screening karte hain, testing karte hain, uske liye bheja gaya tha Hinduja mein, to usme benzodiazepine group ka drugs positive hai.
Drug overdose would point fingers at the prison authorities and the role of an insider. But authorities seem to suggest the involvement of an outsider with an attempt to push forward the food poisoning theory. As the Indrani plot thickens, Mirror now asks, how did Indrani or anyone else get access to extra pills inside prison? Was this an attempt to silence Indrani, or did she just get food poisoning? Let's debate.
Well, Indrani Mukherjee, the celebrity inmate of jail since 2015, prime accused in the murder of her daughter, which took place in 2012, has now been diagnosed of a drug overdose. Remember, she collapsed and was taken to hospital on Friday, and there were all kinds of theories floating. One of the theories that were floating around was whether someone tried to poison her in an attempt to get rid of her or to kill her. Was it an attempt to murder? Was it an attempt to suicide? Or was it a drug overdose? The doctors have now confirmed just a couple of hours ago that she overdosed on an antidepressant. Incidentally, she overdosed on a similar antidepressant in 2015 when she was first taken to jail. How is she getting access to antidepressants inside of jails? What's going on? Are our jails so slack? Is the VVIP treatment that's given inside of jails so slack that not only do people get special treatment, they also get access to narcotics with the ability to overdose? There are smaller stories now coming in, like a report that when the police constable was asked to take the sample for the toxicology testing from JJ Hospital to Hinduja Hospital, he apparently or allegedly spilt it on the way, came back 2 hours later and said there was a leak. I'm sorry, I've lost the sample. The second time, of course, there was a constable, there was a doctor who accompanied that constable, and then the toxicology actually happened. And we understand now from the doctor, the press conference held by JJ, that it was benzodiazepine. Let me bring in right now on the phone line Mr. Subramaniam Swamy, who is a member of parliament with the BJP. Mr. Swamy, thank you for joining us. He joins us, I understand, from New Jersey. Thank you for making time to be with us. I understand it's early morning there. Dr. Swamy, you tweeted a couple of hours ago about your concern with regard to this particular case and the hospitalization of Indrani Mukherjee. What is your concern right now?
Well, she's a very crucial witness. She has been very firm, very specific. She was upfront in saying she would directly report it before a magistrate, which means it binds her. And then suddenly they say that she had an overdose of some tranquilizer or something like that. Well, I've seen this kind of thing being trotted out as an excuse in other cases. Also, in the case of Sunanda Pushkar's murder, they said she had taken an overdose of Alprax, and Alprax was never prescribed for her. And so further investigation showed that it was actually forcibly put down her throat, and that it was a murder, and so an FIR was registered on murder. Here, too, I think we need to get into it because very high stakes are there. So Chidambaram loses his entire political career because of this kind of expose that has come on the way he made money for himself and his son. So he's capable, you know, these people who are with Mr. Chidambaram, Mr. Chidambaram and such, they stand to gain if she suddenly disappears. And so, therefore, it must be investigated and satisfy yourself that it was indeed something that happened accidentally.
Dr. Swami, if I'm not mistaken, I'm just reiterating here, allegation here, your suspicion here is that this has something to do with the Chidambaram case where she is a witness. You think there's someone there with an axe to grind to perhaps get rid of her?
Yes, only people like Chidambaram have the kind of access that they had to be able to administer anything to her. And where the hospital authorities look the other way, Congress has been in power for a long time in Maharashtra, and most of the jail staff was being appointed during the Congress period. So I think that would be my first suspicion, or which would require investigation. Whether,
right.
First of all, let's establish.
Dr. Swami, this is obviously, as you understand just as well, a very serious allegation at this point. We also understand that in 2015, Indrani Mukherjee overdosed with a similar drug in a similar manner. Does that suggest perhaps that there was someone giving her the drug in a hospital late, or, you know, over the last several years, that this was something she was taking perhaps almost recreationally?
All these things need to be documented, you see. Therefore, it's not appropriate now just to go by either hearsay or otherwise. Did she really have this earlier incident? I have not been able to verify it. The question is, now that she's regaining consciousness, she would be able to tell us whether she took it herself or indeed it was forced on her.
Well, and Dr. Swami, since you say that it was perhaps, whether it was forced on her and she took it herself, the big question to ask at this point was, how are these drugs making their way into the jail at all?
Good.
You believe in the culpability now of the jail officers?
Yeah, of course. I'm telling you that these are all people who have been appointed during the Congress period, and Congress has stands to lose heavily if all these financial scandals that we have, I in particular brought before the knowledge of the court, comes out, and the elections are not far away. The stakes are very high. And I'm not saying at the moment that I can categorically say that these people are guilty of the attempted murder, but I would say that this needs to be investigated thoroughly from that angle.
Right. Dr. Subramanian Swami, thank you so much for joining us here on the Urban Debate on Mirror Now. We appreciate your time. Dr. Subramanian Swami, live from New Jersey, as he had tweeted a few hours ago, reiterating that he finds this entire thing very suspicious, and he demands that there be an investigation into how Indrani got access to those drugs and whether there was an attempt perhaps to poison her inside of jail. Now, there are two possible scenarios here, viewers. Possibility of a poisoning inside of jail and the possibility of drugs being accessed inside of jail for recreational use. In both of those cases, the jailers should come under scrutiny, because under no circumstances should drugs find their way into jail at all. Let me open up this panel right now. Joining me on the show, K.K. Manan, senior criminal advocate with the Delhi High Court, Balchandar Shishat, leader with the BJP, Vikram Singh, former DGP Uttar Pradesh, Sujay Kantawala, senior lawyer, Dr. Sujay Kantawala from now on for us, Ramakant Gaur, senior lawyer of the Supreme Court, Dharaj Manjari, former assistant commissioner of police, Mumbai, and of course we also have Dr. Sagar Mundada, psychiatrist, and a young doctor joining us who has also worked at JJ Hospital, so he has some experience specifically with the cases coming out of this particular jail. Let me open this up at this point. If we have Mr. Manan's not with us, but I'm going to come first to Sujay. Sujay, this is worrying.
Very much.
Because it just points to corruption inside of jails.
Absolutely.
Tell us what you think.
It's pathetic. Our jails are in such a pitiable condition. The Supreme Court has again and again taken into account the reports made, the committees which have been set up. For maybe a 500 capacity, there are 5,000 people. How are they going to manage all this? So this breeds corruption, and corruption to the worst level. I think human rights stops outside. When you go inside, it's a completely different world. It's bizarre and very difficult. And considering now into this case, how did she have access? these are prescription drugs which are meant to be administered by the doctor himself or herself. You cannot play around with these pills. They can be life-threatening. And then the police constable who goes to, with the sample, he spills it. Now, this is very dangerous. They don't have their SOPs in place. They are not trained at all. This can lead to switching of samples in very, very sensitive. And this is a sensitive case where she is a witness to a very important issue. And also, she is an accused, main accused in a murder case. So, her life, if it is in danger for any other reason, that needs to be investigated. This can have very dangerous omens.
And let's also remember that this was the same case where there was the death of Manjula Shete, which was also very suspicious. Absolutely. Indrani Mukherjee led a sort of protest inside of jails with the rest of the inmates against the jailers. So there have been a fair amount of problems here. Mr. Vanjari, I'm going to come to you. Obviously, you've seen the inside of our jails. Tell us what you've seen.
I don't deny that there is no corruption inside the jail because there are so many incidences. But in spite of that, there is a manual according to which the jail authorities are supposed to administer the day-to-day affair.
Does anybody follow the manual?
People must follow. If not, then they are the subject to be taken to the news of law through inquiries. Now, in this particular case, what I find that whether in 2015, when she fell sick of the similar nature, what medicine was prescribed to her by doctor, whether it was antidepressant, whether it was a blood pressure tablet or some other regular tablet.
So let me tell you, I have those details, if I may interrupt you, please. So this is from Dr. Waqir Sheikh, who's the professor of medicine at JJ Hospital. Now, he tells us that she was supposed to be given 3 tablets over the last several months, 3 tablets every day after breakfast. Now, these tablets were an aspirin, an antiplatelet drug, and a specific antidepressant. Now, the manner in which these tablets were meant to be administered was the jail official would have to put them in her mouth physically and then give her water. She was not allowed to touch them, so she couldn't have taken them in her hand. She couldn't have hoarded these medicines, hidden them, hoarded them, and then taken them all at once. There should have been absolutely no chance of a overdose whatsoever. Now, it turns out that the drug she actually overdosed on has absolutely nothing to do with these 3 drugs completely. They have not been prescribed at all, which means she was being given access to a 4th kind of drug.
Which is more serious.
Which is more serious here.
And that point need to be investigated thoroughly. As Subramanian Swami has mentioned that she is a witness in a very high profile case. That Sina Bora's murder itself a very high profile case. Now Chidambaram's case is also a very high profile case. So possibilities cannot be ruled out unless and until we conduct a thorough investigation into it. And whosoever are responsible for this kind of mischiefs. Now in looking into the series of incidences, as Kanthamala has mentioned, that constable has spoiled that sample on the way to hospital for testing. So it's also a matter of concern. He has not only lost the sample, but I say he has lost his job. Such people, if deliberately doing it, having some calculated mind behind it, they should be suspended from their services. They are not supposed to stay in service for their negligence.
But, you know, I want to bring in Mr. Shirsat, the leader of the BJP here in Mumbai. Mr. Shirsat, what sort of administration is this in these jails where these people have access to food from outside? They have access to drugs from outside. Is this a jail or is this a 5-star hotel?
See, the inquiry is going on and as you have just now mentioned, the pills are given by the jail administration staff to the concerned person. They are not allowed to take it in hand also.
No, no, the pills are supposed to be given by the staff.
Supposed to be given.
In that manner. Whether they are or not, we don't
know. So, antidepressant, she was supposed to take 3 pills. But you take any pill in your hand, you never know. Dr. Mundra will support me. You never know what is power of the pill, 100 mg or 200 mg.
That is why looking, to be given by the doctor.
Looking at the pill, one cannot decide power of the pill. That is number
what
one.
What does that have to do? Nobody has to decide. The doctor has prescribed.
Yes,
you follow the prescription.
That is what I am telling you.
How many people have been suspended from this jail, please tell me, after this incident?
See, the jailers in Manjula Shete's case, serious action was taken. In this case, serious action will be taken. Will be taken. But without inquiry, action cannot be taken, yet reports are awaited. Stomach wash has gone for chemical analysis in forensic lab. And forensic lab report, just now you said, it has come. It states the 4th medicine is given. some different medicine other than the prescribed one is given. So what is that medicine? What is the effect? How the medicine has come?
All that information is with us.
All will be punished.
Benzodiazepine has been given. What is the effect? We know all of that. Now, simply, Mr. Shirsad, answer this question.
Yeah.
Jails come under the Home Ministry.
Yes.
Yes. The jailers are alleging that this was food poisoning. That when she went to the court last week, she got outside food. She is not allowed to have outside food, which means that there is corruption in the jailing system. Or pills that were not meant to given to her came inside of jail, which is an attempt to murder, which can only have happened in collusion with the jailers. Or she was being given pills to be taken recreationally, which could have only happened in collusion with the jailers. Obviously, any scenario, any which way your investigation comes out, your jailers are at fault. 100%. Are they still there in that jail with the ability to destroy evidence? Who are you fooling when you tell me that you are doing an investigation?
No, we are not fooling anybody. Please remember, yet nothing is established. Food poisoning. Food poisoning is a claim made by press, not by jailer.
Really? Okay.
No jailer has given statement. Give me name of the jailer who has given statement. It was food poisoning. And if at all it is food poisoning, jailer is responsible because food is provided inside. If outside food has reached the jail, again he is at fault. Inside food is not good, then again he is at fault. So jailer is 100% at fault. No jailer will claim that I am at fault, at least, even though if he is in fault. So obviously, no jailer has said outside food poisoning has happened. Somebody might have made loose comment.
Suspicion? What is your suspicion? So if you think you want to wait until
my suspicion is it is not food poisoning.
Then
she has been given the medicine. There is something fishy about the medicine pills, either the dose, its power, or the ingredients itself. Looking at the color of the pill, one cannot make out what it is. So Indrani Mukherjee, I don't think she had access to additional medicines and she has taken additional. This is something fishy. See, jail is full of hardcore criminals. So you can't expect something good from criminals. Good behavior from criminals, it is not possible. So the jailers, policemen, jail administration, some outsiders, hand in gloves with each other. It is suspicious what Dr. Subramaniam said. She is prime accused.
We expect the good
in murder
from
case,
the government,
but she is prime witness.
All right,
she's
one second. Mr. Shirsad, let me point out. One second. Very easy right now to point fingers at somebody else, but you are running a very, very lax jailing system.
Yes.
And the reason why we are talking about this on the show is because tomorrow, any murderer can go to jail and have 5-star treatment, walk in and out of jail as they please, or murders can happen in jail, which means that you have changed nothing. You're sitting here and telling me Congress. You've been in power for over 4 years. Why are you still complaining about it? What can the Congress do when you are in power?
No, Congress cannot do anything. But,
so then?
But the administration, which has become corrupt in Congress regime, it will definitely see government has changed. Administration has not changed.
Okay, Mr. Shirsad.
Police officials are not changed.
No, one second.
That's a very good attempt at transferring the blame.
Now, let me tell you why that doesn't hold. Because the Manjula Shete case, which happened last year, was in the same jail, and the jailers were suspended and replaced after that by your administration.
Yes,
this
they
is
were
not
suspended.
The jailers that you inherited from the Congress administration.
No,
so now why are you complaining about the Congress?
No, they were suspended. In this case also, the jailer will be suspended.
No, hang on. You said that the administration is corrupt because it's a Congress administration. I'm telling you it was changed last year.
This is your administration now.
So now who are you complaining about?
It is a habit to the administration. Administration
so
has worked for
the
last 30
IAS
years.
So now the entire IAS is corrupt. So you want to replace everybody. Let's throw them all out. Full IPS, full IAS, full IFS. Who else do we want to throw out, Mr. Burr?
If necessary, everybody should be thrown out. If necessary. If found guilty, everybody should be thrown out. If found corrupt, everybody should be thrown out.
Nobody should be spared. Who's going to find them corrupt?
Cool down. I'll tell you. If you say a system is corrupt, if you say the administration is corrupt, look in our hierarchy, a constitutional law hierarchy, we have a governance and administration, shashan or prashashan. Prashasan is not going to change as per the whim of Sasan. Karan Tumidar Matli, everybody should be removed and everybody, so that is not a possibility. Simple funda is administration is to be governed by the people who are in government. And that's the whole responsibility comes to the Home Department under which the jail authorities are functioning. Administration can be corrected. Administration, if going in a way vary, it can be brought to the track and it can be done well. So that sort of control you are supposed to exercise on the system. It is a system established under the constitution. You have not established the system. It is already established system. You are supposed to govern the system properly.
Let me bring in Vikram Singh. Mr. Singh, how much of this are you buying?
Pay, nothing would be more amusing and preposterous than what my political friend has just said. Taking the point of Dr. Sujay Kantawala ji, there couldn't have been a more grotesque self-goal than this, what my political friend has just mentioned. Firstly, whether it is inside or outside, you cannot absolve yourself of your moral, legal and administrative responsibility. One, whether the drug was given inside, whether it was smuggled, whether it was food poisoning. Now coming to the fact that this happened in 2015, this has happened again, is bad enough. The constables spilling the sample, I mean, I have seldom come across in my career when such a thing happened. I do hope that you have dismissed the constable by now. And if not, sir, do a bit of soul searching. There will never be that golden moment in our lives and careers when you will inherit God-sent IES, IPS and upright people from heaven like manna dropping down from the heavens. That is not going to happen. Sir, you have to govern and govern with a firm hand. You have to be cruel to be kind, to dispose of the corrupt and the inefficient. And in this case, I strongly suspect that it is a very sloppy way to attempt to murder a person. There are very sophisticated ways to do things, and I'm sure those who have such high stakes will be more well-informed than to do a try. She is on to drugs, and the whole institutionalized corruption that you see in the jails has facilitated. They work at the behest. They work like their most obedient and loyal menials and servants, as in the case of Salman Khan, as in the case of Indrani, and in the case of other high profile under trials and criminals. In this case, I would fault the jail staff for succumbing to the temptation of catering to her fetishes and weaknesses. They should not have. And now that the thing has gone happen, somebody is saying it is food poisoning. Somebody is saying that it is overdose. How did it happen in the first place? I think it needs a course correction, and the earlier we do it, the better. As Dr. Kantawala has said, it is nothing short of a nightmare to go inside the jail today. If it is 500, it is more than 5,000. What does not happen in jail, whether it is sodomy, whether it is suicide, attempt to commit suicide, whether a toilet meant for two people being used by 200 people, and the worst kind of food being given to the under trials, well, I will stop at that.
Ramakant Gaur, you know, and this is something our viewers should know. Viewers, the particular drug that has been found in her system was found in her system also in 2015. The same drug, same method, same modus operandi. She came back to the same hospital with the same symptoms as well. And then she was treated. So this is not a drug that someone smuggled in and tried to kill her with. This is a drug perhaps that she's taking recreationally and somebody is making available to her. Ramakant Gaur.
Jail fails the human life. I see another angle as well. It is a repetition of 2015 into 2018. And it is repetition of 1984 in 2017 as well. In 1984, Supreme Court has observed that there are a number of anomalies in the jail administration, which is overcrowding, maltreatment, torture, sodomy, etc. They were in 1984 they found 9 such things. In 2017, September 2017, Supreme Court again observed that even the jail manual has not been made in spite of repeated directives of the Supreme Court. This is the state of affairs. Jail manual 2016 is being implemented now. It could not take shape irrespective of Supreme Court directives. This is a state of affairs. Now, the statistics are a bit bitter. They are not what I am saying. This is what Supreme Court observed in its judgment. 126 unnatural deaths in 2012. In 2013, 115. In 2014, 195 deaths. In 2015, 115 deaths. In 2016 and 17, more than 100 deaths. Unnatural deaths. This is a state of affairs. Shoddy state of affairs. We are not oblivious of the fact that the blades are available in the jail, drugs are available in the jail, cameras are, mobile phones are available to the criminals in the jail. What we are talking about, Manjula Shetty's case, we have seen your jail only, sir. So if the government representative says, if the ruling party representative says it is something relating to Congress, yes, it is something related to Congress, which was there in 94 also, in 84 also. But it has not been changed in 2018.
Yes. All right, let's open this up. What have you been doing? Let's open this up right now. Let me open this up. Let me open up this entire panel, Mr. Shirsat. You want to respond to the questions being asked by Mr. Singh and Mr. Ramakangor? What have you been doing for the last 4 years? Because this jailing administration comes directly under the Home Ministry, which is the Chief Minister of Maharashtra.
See, Home Ministry is looking into jail improvement, manual following, but it has not happened, unfortunately, till now.
Why not?
It has not happened. See, it is to be implemented by administration, not by Chief Minister or Home Minister.
Then why do we vote for
them? They are governing, but you are governing not kids. They are not kids.
No, hang on.
They are not.
We voted for you for a change. You are telling me no change has happened because it's the administrator.
Change cannot take overnight when bad habits are there. You can't change bad habits overnight. You can't change corruption overnight. It takes time. Corruption in governance has stopped.
2018 is not overnight.
Earlier in Congress government, Home Minister, and the corruption was at the top level.
Which is why we voted your government into power.
Now governance level corruption is not there.
What guarantee do you have that government level corruption is not there?
I have a guarantee.
Because today we are not talking about it. That's why you're bringing it up.
I'm giving you guarantee.
So hang on. So what you're telling me, Mr. Shirsat, is then you're saying this. Because the Chief Minister has too many things on his plate, he can only concentrate on one thing at a time. So he's looking at governance, he's not looking at police and jails.
No, that is what you are concluding. I have never said so.
Then why has he not done this work?
I have never said so.
Why does he have to be Chief Minister and Urban Development Minister and Home Minister?
That Mera now will not decide. That government of Maharashtra and BJP will decide.
Okay, you will decide everything. Now you tell me. Why has this work not been done?
Sir, Supreme Court
I have the full authority to ask you this question.
Yes, definitely.
Why has it not been done? How can you sit here 4.5 years into your term and tell me that the job has just not been done?
Let me make it very clear. The food poisoning story is available in the press. No statement is released by government or by jail administration regarding food poisoning.
There is a possibility
of food poisoning. Such comment or probably loose comment somebody must have made. But there is no official statement by government.
Mr. Shirsat, you said that no changes have come into the jailing system in Maharashtra, but we have fixed the governance system. My question to you is, why have no changes come into the jailing system in Maharashtra? Why are there criminals in Maharashtra's jails being allowed to go where they please, eat what they want and take drugs inside of jails?
Again, you are putting something in my mouth. I never said there is no change. I said there is change in governance, there is change in government, political wing. Still, long time will take to change the administration and especially police administration.
There was a traffic
constable. Which is more prone to the corruption.
There was a traffic constable
And where money is easily available.
There were two young bikers
yeah.
who brutally murdered a traffic constable. After that, we had a debate where the videos came on TV. Remember, Faye? And where they said that our quarters are such.
Yes.
So let's go out of the jail. The quarters, the police quarters. What have you done about our police people? The police people who guard us, their quarters are leaking. They're in such horrible state. Mr. Vanjari will bear me out on this. Poor widows came and I said, remember, Faye, I said we'll file a PIL for them.
That is whatever.
That is true, but that does not give them authority
exactly,
for corruption.
Exactly.
No. Nobody is justifying corruption.
But this government
had promised them a complete redo of their quarters in
that
Berlin.
That is being done.
When is it being done?
All police housing, very
How
big scheme is
take?
All big scheme is going on. Every policeman will get a house.
Mr. Sharma, I'm sorry. Your answers are just not satisfactory. Mr. Vanjari, you know, it's unfortunate here that because your government has not been able to do its job, you are willing to write off the entire police force.
The
Mumbai police force is among the hardest working police force in the country. You overburden them. You make them do VIP. You make them do VIP security. You send them to give security to Bollywood stars. And to politicians, you underpay them, you overwork them. And you have the audacity today to say the entire police force is corrupt. Mr. Vanjari, do you want to respond to that?
Yeah,
I think that's very unfortunate.
I would like
Mr.
to
Chisar.
Respond with a concrete example of Sanjay Dutt. In Sanjay Dutt's matter regarding that furlough and parole, what mistakes and what blunders the jail authorities have committed, filing their reports, then again changing report. In that fashion, in that matter, High Court of Mumbai wanted to conduct the inquiry and they asked Home Department to conduct the inquiry and submit the report. So far, no report has been submitted. So it means that somewhere the state of governance is protecting the corrupt state of administration, and that we must admit under the facts which are open and very clear. Here, why repeatedly such thing happening in the jail? Somebody should take accountability. Somebody should spell out that yes, it is the person who is responsible. And responsibility goes to governance.
To add to what Mr. Vanjari just said, it's two important words: timelines and accountability.
Yes,
I think these two definitions are just not understood.
Yeah.
That there is time is the essence of everything, and there is accountability.
Yes. Yes. Let me bring in Dr. Sagar Mandara, who's a doctor who has worked in JJ Hospital, where I'm assuming lot of the patients have been brought in from this particular jail over the years. Dr. Mandara, clear this up for us. Mr. Shirsat seems to think that this might have been a wrong drug that was administered. Now, it is very clear from the doctors, from the professor of medicine, JJ Hospital, Dr. Sheikh, who said that she was only on 3 tablets a day after breakfast, a hypertensive drug, which is high blood pressure, aspirin, antiplatelet drug, and of course one antidepressant. Now, for her to have wound up with enough of this particular drug in her system to be rushed to the hospital, could that have been an innocent mistake?
Right. Right. Now, see, first of all, I've been hearing the entire discussion. One thing I really want to make a note of is, whatever the panelists have been talking about the jail system in our country, at least in Bombay, what I've seen, many prisoners are brought to JJ Hospital from Baikala Jail, from Arthur Road Jail, and most of them have such deplorable conditions that most of them, when they go into the jail, they end up with mental health issues like depression, and they become druggies there. So people who are not druggies outside, they go inside and they have the availability of all the drugs on the world and they get them very easily. So basically they go to jail and they become druggies there. I think that is one thing which is very shameful, and it has been going on since a lot. I've seen this with my own, I've seen it myself when people come to JJ Hospital. Secondly, what you're talking of, the drug that is being, you know, talked of, the benzodiazepine, it is not per se an antidepressant. It is primarily a sleeping pill. It is generally given to patients who have a lot of issue while, if they are not able to sleep. Now, one important note of caution here is that it is of utmost importance that it has to be given in a supervised way. Because many of these patients who have these issues, they sometimes tend to have suicidal thoughts and they take the entire strip of medicine and they just take it. So the chances of doing suicide are very high. So they just cannot be given in the hands of the patient. It always has to be that somebody else gives them to them, and the doctor does not prescribe them beyond a certain limit. What we are seeing here seems to be a very deliberate attempt. I don't know by whom, but this is just a sleeping pill. It's not an antidepressant, and it is just given in very minimal doses for it to have a overdosage and all the complications that Indrani is having, it has to be purposefully given by somebody who knows the side effects. And that's no, what
so,
it is.
So,
it has
so
to be
Dr. Mundara, tell us this. For her to have had an overdose, for her to have had an overdose, how many pills should she have taken? At one time.
See, ideally, I'll tell you two things. What the doctors prescribe if... Yeah, ideally what happens is when you don't... when you're having these sleep issues, when you're having a little bit of depressive symptoms, we generally give one or two pills, a maximum of three pills. But the overdosage, at least one strip, that is 10 medicines, that is 10 tablets must have been given for her to have all those overdose complications. Now, that can happen either when the patient is suicidal and takes it himself or herself, if there is unsupervised medication. And the other thing is, if somebody is giving it to them or mixing it in their food, that is the other option. There at least has to be 10 tablets of 2 milligrams that need to be given for them to have such kind of an overdosage problem.
Well, Vikram Singh, so here are the possibilities. Either she had access to drugs that she was taking on her own, unsupervised and unprescribed, or someone was mixing them into her food, which is even scarier. Both of these cases point to high levels of corruption among jail authority.
Corruption and incompetence, or both. The doctor has given a first-hand account of what could be the possible permutations and combinations. I dare say from the experience of 2015 that Indrani is too intelligent a person to swallow something hook, line and sinker in this manner. I think it is an overdose of drugs and that she's accustomed to, and she has taken it on her own volition and duly facilitated by a corrupt jail system. Our political friend has given, Dr. Kantawala, in your wisdom, I would like to bring to your notice that this is a very revolutionary idea of administration which our political friend has given, that there is compartmentalization in governance. One is the top level governance and the second is the lower level of governance of which you are not accountable. And that lower level can do whatever they can and the upper level can sit in total satisfaction that yes, I have done what I could. Whether the delivery happens or not happen, whether the people are happy or not happy, it is none of the concern of the Mantralaya. The Mantralaya can sit in luxury and of course wish them well. And unless there is a delivery at the last doorstep, sir, you cannot wash your hands off of your accountability. You cannot say that this compartment is okay and the second compartment is B and the third compartment I am not responsible.
Right.
This is one of the most callous things that I have heard in recent years.
So the question that we must ask at this point is, why has no one been suspended? Why has no one been arrested? Obviously, this is a matter of grave concern. Drugs have made their way into the jail. Whether on purpose, on request of the inmate, or on an attempt to harm the inmate, both of these things are very serious. And
obviously,
nobody has been arrested or suspended at all.
Suspension.
We have this constant talk of an investigation.
Suspension, Faye, is the norm. Because if there is something like this, as serious as this, suspension pending inquiry. Now, if something like that it happens in any office or any government office, the pune or whoever is suspended first. So this is an interim measure which has to be taken, because that person who is the errant person or the group of conspirators who are working, they are still there.
Yes.
They are lurking in that jail still.
Destroying evidence.
So they are destroying evidence.
Threatening other inmates.
And exactly, that impartiality is going. And every minute it is vanishing. So as Mr. Vikram Singh just now said, and Mr. Vanjara, both of them have said and joined hands on this issue, and we are all one on this issue, that there has to be suspension immediately. Otherwise, we are making a mockery of this whole thing and we are not setting a precedent and role and for others to shudder.
Well, our viewers have begun to call us in. Vinod Kamath on the phone line from Mumbai. Vinod, go ahead.
Well, Faye,
yes.
One of my friend who was in the Arthur Road jail has told me that he was there for almost 90 days for some frivolous charge, but leave aside that, he has informed me in that everything is available for money, drug, booze, or even girls. And that is completely anarchy in the Arthur Road jail. And this is as late as 2016, where Mr. BJP government is fully in control, including the chief minister. So this is nothing new. And this is just as even the doctor was saying the same thing, that the drugs are available cheap inside the jail. And the BJP government is doing nothing. In fact, they must be complicit with that.
Right. So the drugs are available. Everything is available inside of jail. Naresh on the phone line from Delhi. Naresh, go ahead.
Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening.
This is Naresh here.
Yes.
And good evening to all panelists. Ma'am, my query is why these drugs or whatever happens, these kind of jail mishaps happen only with the celebrity, celebrity jail, what do you call them, accused.
Mm.
Why is it not happening with a common person? And why is it that when they get dosed, overdosed, and they are sent to JJ hospital only? There could be some nexus between the hospital authority and the jail authorities also.
Well, JJ hospital, I believe, is the closest government hospital to that particular jail, which is why when someone has to be rushed to a hospital, that's the hospital they go to. And I also understand that, normally there is a jail doctor who's called in. And if the jail doctor recommends hospitalization, then the inmate is moved to a hospital. But important questions being asked by our viewers. Ramakant Gaur, I believe we have KK Manan joining us as well. Mr. Manan, corruption in our jails, and very important question that was brought up. Why is it always celebrities or rich people or powerful people who have these kind of stories about them, sort of luxury inside of our jails? Would you say that this points to luxury inside the jails, corruption inside our jails, or an attempt to murder inside the jail? Mr. Manan.
Yes, will I say that jails are den of corruptions? Not in one jail, in every jail, everywhere in this country, and not only one topic of this corruption and the facilities for celebrities, even the common man. If he can afford money, without money they don't run even a single step. And sometime if somebody does not pay the money to them, they in fact torture the through inmates, whoever the prisoner and who is in a judicial custody or is spending jail after conviction. Everybody is suffering in the jails. No control of the authorities are there, and not only for celebrity, of course, for celebrity, if the with the permission of the jail superintendent or jail DGP, IG, whoever the in charge there, they can have each and everything provided for them. And even Tehad, I met one of the person, very famous person, when I was doing the case in Jodhpur also. So when a person goes there to meet the inmate, the prisoner, he can take number of things there. As one of my friend just was telling, that booze, this and that, this is correct to some extent, and you have seen it, that the Bihar person, UP person, that whoever the Bahubali, these people used to be taking each and everything, mobile phones. And I can go one step further even. In few jails, ma'am, the person can be released in the night, and he, of his own, comes back in the morning in the jail. He can spend his night at his residence also in few jails. It is little bit having, hearsay, or you can say my personal knowledge, whatever it is, you can say it. But it's a jail authorities doesn't have any control on the corruption, and their officers, their employees are indulging in corruption at a large scale. There is no doubt at all, and you can take anything in the jail premises, even the drugs are available there. Is it possible without the connivance of the jail authorities? It is not. So nobody can say today that common man means common man also can get with the money, but who can't get the facilities are the people who are unable to do, who are the poor people, unable to meet the expenses of even the lawyers. Litigation so expensive for them also, even the lawyers.
Well, here's the question. Here's the question we have to ask, right? And this is not about
even they are indulging in corruption.
Yes, and this is not about this one particular case or this
even
one particular
they are indulging in corruption.
Yes, or this one particular state. Remember, Shashikala is lodged in a prison in Bangalore, which has a terrible reputation of corruption, and that is a Congress government. This is a BJP government. If you go to Bengal, there's a different government. If you go to Tamil Nadu, it's a different government. Every government across the board, every jail across the board seems to have similar symptoms of corruption, which means, Mr. Shirsat, there is no difference between these governments.
See,
nobody has the intention of cleaning up.
Basically, in this case, there are three theories. One is food poisoning floated by XYZ.
Which you are refuting.
Which government has not endorsed.
Okay.
Second is drug overdose. Forensic lab is examining chemical analysis. That report might have come to your hand. But the details will come.
The doctor had a press conference today. Press conference.
Yeah.
It has not come to my hands.
Then drug overdose. And third is attempt to murder. What I feel, who will be benefited out of attempt to murder? Will BJP be benefited out of attempt to murder?
Mr. Shirsat, you are missing the point of this conversation
Karthi,
completely.
Chidambaram and his son.
You know, it's very easy to make allegations. You are missing the point of this conversation.
They will be benefited
the witness
out of the murder attempt.
Who is protect?
Okay.
Obviously, that is what is to be investigated.
Okay, so you are telling me that there are people in this country who have a motive.
Yeah.
Right?
You
are alleging murder.
Obviously.
Of a person in jail custody.
Yeah.
How did they get access to her?
They will get access to the jail administration, which is corrupt.
Whose jail administration are we talking about here? Who's in charge? Who do they report to, these jail administration people?
Every constable is reporting to CM. Do you mean to say so?
Yes.
Definitely not.
So if
see,
you
there
know,
are different
no,
levels.
No, okay. So here's my
there
next
are,
question. One second,
levels.
One second. Okay, fine, fine.
Mr.
You cannot Chandra possibly.
Was,
okay, you cannot
Panjali
possibly. One second, one second.
The
Mr. Shirsat, you cannot. Okay, fine. You cannot possibly guard every person in this state. But you have right now the extreme intelligence to know that Karthi Chidambaram has a motive here.
No,
you know that there is a person of interest. Why didn't you keep her safe? That you could have done.
See,
you could have watched this one person very, very carefully. If you know that you, if you think you know something, if you want to make allegations on national television, why would you watch it?
Corrupt people cannot be identified. Even criminals are from our society.
Mr. Balchandra Shirsat,
criminals are from our society.
Bhrashtachar Mukt Bharat, kisne bola tha?
Bhrashtachar Mukt Bharat bola hai.
See, now you're telling me you can't identify them. Aap mukt kaise karenge?
Uske baad Modi ji aur Devendra ji ke sarkar mein bhrashtachar hua nahi hai. Bhrashtachar hua nahi hai. Not a single case
आप,
of
आप आधे घंटे वेट कीजिए इसके बाद हम नीरव मोदी के बारे में बात करने वाले हैं
तो नीरव मोदी इज बेबी ऑफ चिदंबरम प्लीज रिमेम्बर नीरव मोदी वाज गिवन ऑल फैसिलिटीज लोन्स मल्या
अशोक पंडित इज दैट इज अ कन्वर्सेशन आफ्टर 9 o'clock अशोक पंडित इज ऑन द फोन लाइन बट आई हैव गुड आंसर्स फॉर दैट क्वेश्चन आल्सो अशोक पंडित प्लीज गो अहेड
हाय गुड इवनिंग सर यू नो एज अ सिटीजन ऑफ दिस कंट्री देयर आर वेरी टू सिंपल क्वेश्चंस आई फील लाइक आस्किंग the politics of this state.
Yes, please.
Here we are talking about a very high profile case where somebody was killed, a daughter was killed, and the entire media, entire country is talking about this case. It's a high profile case.
Yes.
Now, if the system, the police and the jail authorities are not able to protect this girl, it itself proves that there's a failure. So when you're going in for an inquiry, the first thing, if at all they were really serious about it, they should suspend all the senior police officials guarding the jail because jail authorities have failed in protecting this woman. So how can you go in for an inquiry without suspending the senior officials of the jail and leave the inquiry to them only?
Yes.
That means it's a sham.
Yes.
So what I personally feel that all the senior officials of the jail, all those officials who are responsible for the jail, were looking after the jail, system. They should be out first. They should be asked to resign. They should be suspended from the jail, and the inquiry should be committed. Whether it is a case of murder or whatever it is, nobody wants to know that now. My contention as a citizen is: I want to ask the politicians sitting on your panel: is that have you not failed in protecting this woman? Have you not failed in your duty? You mean I mean to say. That Home Ministry is under you, the government is under you. Are you not supposed to take the responsibility which has happened, which tomorrow if anything would have gone wrong, you would have been answerable to people. So my contention, my question to The government,
very quickly answer this question. Who are you answerable to? Were you not responsible when someone is in your literally custody to actually keep them safe?
I fully agree with Mr. Ashok Pandit. The investigation is on. Reports will be tabled. Some reports are tabled today. A very strict action will be taken. People will be suspended. And if required, they will be dismissed. But not without inquiry, not without report. Not overnight, not within 1 hour.
The whole point of a suspension.
So definitely
and
action was taken
lines.
In earlier case, Manjula Shetty's case. This case also, action will be taken. 100% I agree with Ashok Pandit.
Apart from action, Mr. Balachandra, if she is going to be a crucial witness in the case of Chidambaram,
yes.
I think you should give a priority to protect her.
Yes.
Because thereby, war between you and other your rival
parties
will be there. So you can protect. The interest you give Jet security or Y
security
is not a question. You are supposed to protect her.
But
before concluding it.
Okay, thereafter you get Jet security.
Yes. But before concluding
two panel discussions.
But before concluding it, let me address the question asked by Dr. Mundhara. I know he is a psychologist, but he has touched upon a very important point saying a normal people goes in the jail and in jail they become drug addict. Why it is so? It leads to the theory of suicide in this particular case of Indrani because Dr. Idris when asked, Dr. Sekh when asked her after she regained the consciousness that who has given you the pill and how much pill you have taken, she remained consciously silent on that. So there is a possibility that out of that unbearable depression or frustration, she was tempted to take some extra pills and end up her life.
You know, this is the second time it is happening. So I just want to point out just this much, right? We have a representative of the government who constantly tells us that we have to investigate. By all means, go ahead and investigate. Nobody's telling you not to investigate. In the meantime, it is obvious. Any one of the theories you want to look at, those drugs should not have found their way inside that jail at all. At all. It is obvious that the jailers here are corrupt. And these are jailers that you suspended and replaced less than a year ago, which means these are your jailers. You have, at this point, you should have put in people you are confident are not corrupt.
100% agree.
No, 1 second. Second point. You told me that there is a possibility of an attempt to murder. How dare you sit here on national television and tell us someone who is a prime accused in a murder, a prime witness in a second case, a very, very high profile inmate right now, had an attempt to murder while in your custody, while in the custody of the jail. Why aren't you keeping this person safe? Why aren't you keeping this person under special watch? And this is, let me tell you, not the first time it has happened. 3 years ago in 2015, same drug, same overdose, same inmate, same jail, same doctor. You should have known better. Which means that there is laxity from top to bottom and you have simply not done your job. We have to wrap up this conversation here, but it boils down to this, viewers. There is a reason why we have to keep discussing this. On one hand, we put pressure on the government, on the law and order machinery, on the courts to prosecute and to throw those who are corrupt and those who are criminals in jail. But what happens once they go to jail? They have ACs, they have food, they have drugs, they have alcohol. It's a holiday. It's a five-star holiday. Why would anybody be afraid of the law in our country if they can have access to drugs? And worse still, why would anybody be afraid of the law in the country if they can slip a policeman a drug to murder an inmate? Everything about this story is wrong. Everything about this story points to corruption on every possible side. And as regular Indians, we should be really, really worried because tomorrow someone could try to murder us or someone could murder us and never ever face the book. Think of Gauri Lankesh. Think of the journalists who are shot point blank. Think of the RTI activists who are murdered. Innocent people who are on the wrong side of crime because criminals have no fear in this country. The Banana Republic. Thanks for watching.